Marlai’ah. If you're not, welcome back, y'all. Let's get into this tutorial. Before we start, if you're not already subscribed, please do that. Please like the video, please save it, share it, all that good stuff. But let's get into it. So I'm gonna start by doing my first initial part in the back of her head, ear to ear. So I start at the top of her ear and then go all the way over to the other one. Now you'll see me applying jam to the part that I just created. This is allowing me to go back through and make that part super crispy. When you put the jam on there, it's just like something about how the hair separates and allows you to part through and really create that straight line. So that's what I'm doing here. Now you want to begin parting your first real row. So when I make that section back there, I already know that I want that entire section to be about 2 to 3 rows depending on the style. So I just go ahead and I make my first row and I just go straight across like I did exactly parallel to the one above it. Then once you have that parted out, you want to begin making your parts that are vertical. That's going to be like create the actual boxes for the braids. When I'm pre-parting like this, you'll see that I like to actually take some jam and then twist the part itself. Just so it'll stay in place, it won't be accidentally combining with anything that's next to it, and I'll be able to just grab the part and go as I braid. It makes the process so much faster when you pre-part. So now I'm just showing y'all how I set my hair up on my rack. I didn't actually end up using the 2 strands of braiding hair that y'all see there. I only used this kinky hair and then also the curls to do the braids. So you just seen that I broke the hair into 2 pieces and now I'm kind of putting them together at the ends and then separating those into 3 pieces so I can have the 3 strands of my braid. This is kind of blurry and it's not really the best angle, but I'm going to show you guys this at many different angles throughout the video, so if you don't get it right now, don't worry about it, you'll be able to. So at the very top, I just continue to do the braiding pattern until I'm really comfortable that it's anchored enough into her real hair, and then I'll just combine everything into 2 pieces and begin twisting. Shoot. We wanted her braids to be longer, so right here you're going to see me adding in an additional piece of hair for length. I just put it in with the exact two pieces that I'm twisting and then continue twisting the exact same way down. So now I'm just continuing the parts all the way around her head. You start at the temple and then just meet at the other side of the temple, basically. Just create straight parts. Really nothing special, the exact same way that we did the other parts at the back of her head. So now I'm creating her vertical parts. I start in the middle of the row so I can make sure that it creates like that perfect brick layer look. You don't want the parts and boxes to sit exactly on top of each other. So by starting in the middle, you'll create that brick look. So here I am again showing you guys the three pieces to begin the braid. You're gonna take your hair down, comb it out, put jam on it, all that good stuff, and then begin braiding it in like you would a box braid. Now you're going to see right here, I combined them into two different pieces and I began twisting. Now I'm showing you guys how I add the curls in. I combined both sides of the curls to both sides of my twist, and I just added in and continued twisting down the exact same way that I added in that extra length here. As I'm twisting, pay attention to the motion that my wrist does. It's like rotating back, and that's me twisting the hair before I actually wrap it around. And by twisting that one side, you're going to create kind of like that spiral tight twist effect that you're going to want. After this one, you guys, I'm going to speed up the video a little bit, so if you need to, you can change your playback speed in the YouTube settings to make it slower, but I'm going to speed it up just so I won't lose you guys' attention and I'll be able to get through it without the video being too long. I began clipping up the curls just because they were getting in my way and it was kind of annoying. So that's something that y'all can do too if y'all having an issue with the curls, like trying to stay within the twist or anything, just clip them up the way.
show off. Daddy make a wish, put the cake in your face. And it's not even my birthday.
I'm leaving this clip in regular speed just because it is the only one I did of this angle, and I think it'll be kind of beneficial for y'all to be able to see it from me doing it on this top angle. You'll be able to see how my fingers are moving differently. Please let me know in the comments if y'all like when I record from this angle or what angle y'all like the most. I want to make sure these videos are really beneficial for y'all. Y'all learning from it. It's easy for y'all to understand. Let me know if y'all want me to talk and explain more. Let me know what y'all need from me in the comments so I can make these tutorials really suit y'all needs.
My stones, let it rain. I hide your plane in the bank, coming down like a Dow Jones. When the clouds come, we gone. We Rockefellers, we fly higher than weather, and cheap vibes are better. You know me.
So the whole time I was just putting the braids in, I didn't actually twist down to the bottom. But at this point, I have all of her braids in, and now I'll just be twisting them down to the ends, and then adding the curly pieces to the ends.
Be my star, baby, cause
Now I'm showing you guys how I add the curls and then create the knot. So I'll split the bottom of that braid into three pieces again and begin to braid it down. So that's what I'm doing here. So it goes from a twist with two pieces to a braid with three pieces. Then I grab the curl and I just add it into the braid and I continue to braid. The same way I would add it into the twist and continue to twist, I'm just adding it into the braid and continue to braid. So from that, I pull out that very small piece of hair you can see right there, and I wrap it around and pull it through itself and create a knot. And then I do that multiple times so I can seal the ends of the braid. And I show you guys this multiple times too, so don't worry if you don't get it right now. So here we go again, I'm just braiding down. I separated that twist into three pieces and now I'm adding in a curl and I'll continue to braid down the curl. So here we go again, we separate that small piece out the curl, wrap it around the braid, and then pull it through. Now you have a knot. Do that a few more times and it'll seal it completely and it won't come down. And there we have it, guys. This is the complete style. Let me know how y'all like it. Let me know what y'all want to see from me next. However angles that y'all need me to begin recording from for my next tutorials. Just give me feedback, y'all. Talk to me in the comments.